The Burj Khalifa is currently the tallest building in the world. Today, we'll take a detailed look at the shape of the building and what the different floors are used for. All right, so a little geography. Let's make sure we know where we're at. Here's Africa, Europe, and Asia. Towards the bottom of Asia is a country called the United Arab Emirates. The Burj Khalifa is here in the city of Dubai. It's right in the middle of busy downtown. There's some roads, freeways, surrounding buildings, and places to walk. The Dubai Fountains, which have spectacular shows, and of course, the Dubai Shopping Mall. The building was opened in January of 2010. The highest occupied floor is level 160. Above this point is the spire. The total height of the building is 828 meters. Let's compare it to a few other tall buildings. Here's the second and third tallest buildings in the world, and here's a few others you might recognize. The building has a unique shape. If we look at the base of it, you'll see that it has a Y shape, almost like a flower. It allows the wind to pass around it. We certainly wouldn't want the top of the building to sway in the wind. As the building extends upwards, one of the three petals will shrink in a rotating pattern. So this petal shrinks, and then this one, and then this one. This gives us a spiral effect all the way to the top. The building has three main entrances, one for residence, one for hotel, and one for offices. Let's take a look at what each of the floors are used for. There are hotel suites, residential, people buy and rent living space on these floors, mechanical rooms to make sure the building's working properly, sky lobbies, you can take elevators directly to these floors, observatories for the public to see, office space for companies to rent, there's even a restaurant on the 122nd floor. Broadcasting rooms, and above here is the spire. You'll need to use ladders, and the public generally isn't allowed up here. You'll find all the elevators at the core of the building. This building pushed elevator technology to its limits. There's no elevator that services every single floor. To get to the highest floors, you'll need to first take an elevator to one of the sky lobbies, then get on another elevator to take you the rest of the way. It's a long way up, but just in case you get bored, there's a video screen to keep you entertained. Some of these are actually double-deck elevators. They are able to service two floors at one time. Let's take a look at one of the hotel floors. Once you get off the elevators, you can go to any one of the three wings to find your room. The rooms vary in size from a smaller one-bedroom all the way up to a large and spacious hotel suite at the very end. If you need a bit more of a view, there are more hotel rooms on the 38th and 39th floors. As a tourist, you can ride the elevators to the 124th or 125th floors. If you want to pay a little extra, you can get into another elevator and go all the way up to the 148th floor. I hope you're not afraid of heights. For now, the Burj Khalifa is still the tallest building in the world, but this may change in the coming years. You know what they say about records, they are always made to be broken. This video was made possible by your support on Patreon. If you'd like to help me make more videos like this, then go ahead and check out my Patreon page. I'll put a link for it right here. My name's Jared, thanks for spending a few minutes with me today, and I will see you next time.